Is the invoice accurate to the time that they spent repairing the leaks?
I haven't seen the invoice, so I can't answer.
Can you repeat that?
Yeah, no, but we did this last month, and I can't be given an invoice, so I'll get it in 2 minutes. I'll tell you what, $13,000 sounds like a reasonable to me. They were here, we had two breaks, there was people all over the neighborhood, and it's the same thing that I've been saying since I've been here. You can't shut the valves off. If you can shut the valves off, you're okay. We went to Barrett and Nobes, and we shut it off, but here it wasn't shut off, so then you go to, we come to find out along the way, then you go to Nobes and State. Everything isn't operable, so now you got to go down State Street to try and find a valve you can shut off, and you got to go north on it also because of the way the system is. So that's all. It's been a hell of a lot higher than me. Yeah, well, like I say, that's more than reasonable if you're asking my opinion.
We don't know how many hours they did work.
They were there for hours, I'll tell you that, because I was there with them. And then we had, like you said, we had one break, and then we go over trying to turn off the valve to the east.
assuming your answer is no, we don't know how many hours worked.
Well, by memory, I don't know, I'd have to check my records, but I would say at least 13, 14, 15 hours, yeah.
And you get these packages the same time we do, right?
I got this package 5 minutes ago.
So there's something wrong here, because we should all have this packet at least a couple days before the meeting. Do you have email? I had time to look at these. I worked full time.
Well, thanks, God bless you. If then you got a bill for, if the township got a bill for $13,000 for that night from Austin Tyler, you got it all for free. That's what I'm saying. You asked my opinion, that's my opinion.
Looks like they're 13 hours, right?
13 hours would have been the minimum.
They're all, I mean, foreman was there 8, the other foreman, overtime foreman was there 5, 8, 5, 12.
Well, that's what it says on their invoice, but we don't have any record of that.
I'll verify it, that it was there, yeah, that's correct.
Okay.
All right, any other questions in the bills? Hearing none, can we have a roll call, please?
Greg Vickers.
No.
Barb Boyce.
Yes.
Barb Delaney.
No.
Dean Marotti.
Yes.
Ron Alvarado.
Yes.
Motion carries.
All right. Point, any citizens wishing to address the board here tonight?
Yes.
Please come up and state your name for the minutes for the record. One at a time, then. We've got two people coming up.
You can go ahead. You can go ahead.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Betty Bird. I live on Riley Avenue for 50 plus years. Is it permissible to give you a little handout?
Yes. Municipalization. It
to municipal authorities. According to a 2014 report by the Transnational Institute, around 180 cities in 35 countries have returned control of their water supply to municipalities in the past 15 years. According to an August 31st, 2015 article in Food and Water Watch, investor-owned utilities typically charge 59% more for water services than local government utilities. Investor-owned utilities typically charge 63% more for sewer service than local government utilities. After privatization, water rates increase at about 3 times the rate of inflation, with an average increase of 18% every other year. Thank you.
Thank you. Appreciate your comments. Any other citizens wishing to address the board here tonight?
Stated he would talk to Chris and it would be set straight. Not confident that this would result copies of the hydrant testing procedures in the packet. I assure that hydrant testing are a matter of public record and respectfully request the opportunity to view these records for the last 2 years in Fremont. In closing, myself and fellow taxpayers would like to request that someone be hired that is professional, educated, trained, and properly licensed to maintain the water distribution system for Fairmont, as Chris, who is maintaining it now, is none of those. Thank you.
Ben, thank you for your comments.
Good evening, Supervisor Alvarito and Township Trustees. My name is Delinda Herrick. I live at 302 Ivy Avenue. The Fairmont community is here to demand the management of our water and sewer system be turned over to the city of Joliet. I first heard about a potential sale to Aqua America in May 2018. I was told nothing had yet happened and an actual sale could take at least a year or more. I understood we were at step one of 100. Fairmont was here in November to explain the devastation this sale would have on our community. At that meeting, I requested 12 to 18 months to allow us an opportunity to identify an alternative to Aqua. Here we are only 9 months from learning in May with a serious offer from the city of Joliet to take over management of our system. When HUD issued bonds to create our water system back in the late 70s, due to cross-contamination of our private wells, they instructed that the future of the system be taken over 40% by Lockport and 60% by Joliet. Over the past 2 years, Supervisor Alvarico, you've stated you've spoken to Lockport so many times and were certain they weren't interested and neither was Joliet. I believe you actually now have a statement in writing from the city of Lockport confirming they don't have no interest in following HUD's recommendation. I believe you also have a proposal from Joliet expressing an interest in taking over management of 100% of our water and sewer system. Upon learning of an impending water shortage, I thought, why does everything always happen to Fairmont, around Fairmont, but never for Fairmont? Let's see if we can be part of the 21st century. Next, a meeting was scheduled with Ben Benson, city administrator for the city of Lockport, and others at the city in May 2018. And as predicted by this supervisor, Lockport said they were unable to help us with our water problem due to a lack of funding. Next, Illinois 85th District Representative John Connor approached Mayor Odekirk about helping Fairmont. Since the fall of last year, Fairmont was invited to attend the City of Joliet's Alternative Water Source Study Group meetings. I was subsequently asked to present our request to take over management of our water system to the City of Joliet's Public Service Committee. From the beginning, Joliet City Council members were open and welcoming. This is unique because Fairmont residents can't vote for them. Out of genuine concern for their neighbors, the Public Service Committee and Allison Swisher, Director of Public Utilities, had their Public Works Department examine our system. After doing so and seeing we were already interconnected, they decided taking over management of our system was feasible and would be a good fit for Joliet. Joliet currently manages at least two other unincorporated water systems. The City of Joliet met with Will County, and as they have for some years, Will County agreed to help Fairmont out with monies to facilitate this transition to Joliet. Fairmont has had a very advantageous relationship with Will County over the past several years, with the Fairmont Drainage Project phases 1 through 4, the Housing Rehab Program, the Habitat Housing Refurbishing Program, and We Will Grow Will County built our very first community garden last spring. Fairmont has been making positive improvements for several years with our 15-plus community cleanups. Lewis University has asked to collaborate on a second cleanup this spring. With the new trash hauler, Homewood's Help, I'm planning a spring large item cleanup for Fairmont. We will host our fourth annual health fair Not one person sitting on this board will be directly impacted by this decision. However, Fairmont residents will feel the effects of your decisions long after we are all gone. Despite mumblings that no one wants to be bothered with Fairmont, clearly that's not true because Joliet is poised to do just that. Joliet has been planning for the eventuality of running out of water for a couple of years, and they are narrowing down their choices. If we're part of their system, finally Fairmont will be ready for the future rather than being an afterthought as we have been too many times in the past. Please don't let a few more months stand in the way of our progress. This township has met with our system for at least 42 years. Why are you in such a rush to sail? I do not for one minute think the city of Joliet wants to charge Fairmont residents outrageous rates since we're unable to vote for change. In fact, we're welcome to address the Public Service Committee and City Council at any open meetings they hold. While not the case here, the dissolving of the relationship between Fairmont and the Lockport Township Water Department should feel like an amicable divorce, where everyone walks away unharmed but better off because of the decision we've made. This is a huge decision, and Fairmont residents want the best possible outcome for our residents. None of us, including this board, have ever made such a big decision. All of our research screams privatization is bad. If you have knowledge other than what we have learned, as our elected representatives, you have a responsibility to do your due diligence and make the best selection for the Fairmont community and share why you are making your choice. Bottom line, a hasty decision to partner with the wrong party will have lasting repercussions for all parties involved, especially the residents of Fairmont. Supervisor trustees, please remember, you are not making a 2019 decision, but rather a lifetime decision for an entire community. Thank you.
Thank you, Belinda, for your comments. Anybody else wishing to address the board here tonight?
Well, excuse me, Mr. Supervisor. I was just wondering, since it's still a little bit fresh in our memory, I'd like to address the concerns of Mr. Nick Mara in regards to the safety issue with the fire hydrants before we hear any more comments. I guess I would just like to know what has been done since then to make sure that the other hydrants are in safe operating conditions if there is any problems with fires.
You're asking me?
Yes.
Yeah, they've all been flushed. I've got records of it. Also, the Lockport Township Fire Department, of course, this guy knows so much. But if you talk to them, which I have, Crown Home, Scorey, and a couple other, which Crown and Scorey is the fire chief. A house fire in Lockport Township, Fairmont area, can be put out with one truck alone, just one. And they send multiple anytime, which everybody knows. Accident outside the street, there's eight trucks there, so that's the answer to that, yes. And I flush them all, and I've got the records of it, and I'll dispute what he said. He would not even look at it. Would not even look at it. I said, here, Sunday morning, 7 o'clock, you're so worked up about this, here's my records. I'll meet you there and show you. And he wouldn't even look at it. And I've got another question for you. As long as you guys put me on spotlight, aren't you the same guy that come in here last year in this room over here with two dirty filters and a vial of dirty water?
Yes, I was.
Yes. And the next morning, and I said, I'll call you by 9 o'clock the next morning, and I'll bring the stuff over, and we'll test it right out of your sink. You said you got that water out of your kitchen sink.
Yeah.
And you were not allowed. And I said, and you kept saying, no, it's not that big a deal. I said, wait a minute. You took all the effort to come out here with two dirty filters and a vial of water. I said, you took all that time, but let me finish. When you are perfect, you speak together. And I says, but it ain't. And you were not allowed. You were not. I said, let me come over there and do it. Let's do something. No, no. There was no problem then because there was no camera there. So that's all I got to say.
All right. I'm not going to get into an argument about he said, she said going on here tonight. We are going to plan on going into an executive session to discuss the matter. us move on.
What's your name?
Any other citizens wishing to address the board here tonight?
Until they make a decision, I think we should give them the time. So that would be my request. Thank you.
accepted, so the transfer would be contingent upon three things. And first thing being the receipt of funding to complete $3.5 million in system improvements. Is there, how is that money's coming from the county?
Yes, and I can let the county representatives here speak to that about how that funding would be handled, but it's my understanding that there is a plan, or there are making plans for that funding.
Okay.
It runs me to.
Yeah.
All right, thank you. Okay.
Got
any questions for?
Any other questions for Allison?
No, that's it.
Okay.
My name is Ron Holland. I'm the Community Development Director for Will County. Regarding the question on the letter, point number one, receipt of funding to complete approximately $3.5 million in system improvements over a four-year span. And the more immediate situation is that they're looking for a commitment of $500,000 immediately. Talked to the county board leadership. Money is available right now. It's earmarked for Fairmont. We would simply move the money from the drainage project, which is at hiatus right now, and move it into the water program. The big issue right now, of course, is negotiating the intergovernmental agreement on just how the rest of the $3 million would be allocated over the next 4 years. This is entirely doable in our budget for the block grant program, and I might add that the county board has shown a very positive indication that they want to continue funding Fairmont. Not only are we pulling funds from the block grant program, but there's been an annual allocation for the last 3 years of between $300,000 and $400,000 from the county general fund that augments our CDBG program money. So in talking with the leadership so far, I've heard nothing but a positive indication that they want to continue with the project. They realize that the water situation is a little bit more severe than the drainage, even though we've been spending money on the drainage. How much have we spent on the drainage so far?
We are at about $1.8 million.
$1.8 million. We're running into a couple of stands with the project right now, so we're on hold until we get some further engineering design work done. But we're not abandoning the drainage. We are just putting it on hold until we can resolve that issue. But in the meantime, we want to pick up the water. And the city of Joliet informed Allison and also the city manager have been very favorable in working with us. When we first went into the discussion with Joliet, we understood the nature of the $3.5 million and what needed to be done. And that kind of scared me, to be honest with you, because we could not come up with $3.5 million right at the drop of a hat. But through further meetings with Allison and some of her staff, we realized that this is a progressive situation, which makes the entire situation doable for us. So I just want to go on record saying that we are committed to continue funding this project. We have the funds available within our block grant program, and we see a positive outcome. We're hoping to get the IGA forged for the April meeting, and we're working to that end. So unless there are any other questions, we'd appreciate it.
I got a question.
Yeah.
Your crunching numbers, is that to put the money
received that says that the city council, which I'm assuming is Joliet, approval of an IGA loan with the county of Will for funding of said improvements. And it's just that there is no representation here from the city of Joliet who seems to be in support of this.
I'm here tonight speaking on behalf of the city, and we have had conversations in the public service committee. This was also discussed last Tuesday at a city council meeting, and you know, the letter would not have been drafted and authorized for signature by our state manager if there wasn't support by the Joliet City Council.
Okay, thank you.
I got one issue, and it's mostly just a concern about the timeline. I know Linda and us, you know, we've been discussing this for quite some time, probably close to a year when we first, where this issue was brought forward to us about possible purchase of the system, just out of the blue. You know, I know we were working on obtaining low interest loans, and, you know, we were going to proceed with repairs to the system, and then all of a sudden this comes on the table. Like I said, it's been pending for a while, and I know there was a lot of talks, a lot of discussions amongst Joliet, maybe, and different parties at different times, but they never seemed to include the board for whatever reason. And like I said, one of my big concerns is the fact that, you know, we get information secondhand. Just like you said, there was some discussion about rates going up if Joliet took over, you know, the issue that Lockport, even though when the system was put in and it was designed for Lockport and Joliet to take over 1/3 and 2/3, we know that never happened. I know, depending on who you talk to, everybody has a different reason on why it didn't happen, and it didn't happen. Obviously, when the federal government did that, they thought themselves that that was the best remedy, that that's what was going to occur at some point. And then it didn't happen. So the residents of Fairmont became a little unapproved of our service. So basically, you know, what do we do now? You know, should we be running the system or shouldn't we? And I'm on the take that maybe we shouldn't. This board should not probably be running the system. But I also believe that selling it is probably not the right thing to do. But I'm just getting to where we should do something. And this is dragging on now. Like Barb says, there's no really guarantee that Joliet, if it comes to a vote, is going to approve this. And then we're going to be sitting back here again. We're waiting. You know, now we're 3 months down the line. And now we got, you know, this on our plate again. And the residents unhappy with this board. I just wish that things could have moved forward maybe a little quicker, because this has been pending for a while. And I know there is no real answer why it didn't. And I just said, you know, it's really concerning to me that, you know, we're at this point and there's still a possibility that Joliet and or Lockport, everything sounds good, everything sounds positive, but is there a guarantee, right? No.
Yeah, I'll just mention two things. We were first involved in this in November, so 4 months of working on this, you know, with the county. It is, I know you have been thinking about it, you know, for a year, so, but for our involvement, it has been a pretty short time frame. And secondly, as far as the guarantee, I understand I cannot speak for the
Any other citizens wishing to address the board tonight?
Hi, everyone. My name is Memor Nellis. I am a resident of Fremont, and my concern is this fire hydrant safety issue. So, who knows how many more faulty are out there? From my understanding, nothing has been done since the date to ensure that all these other fire hydrants are in proper working order, because he assures that a truck should be enough to put out a fire in the house. And when that happens, I mean, does he guarantee that that's how it's going to get solved? I mean, if nothing has been done to make sure that none of these fire hydrants are actually working, because he brushes it off, according to him saying that the truck should be enough, that's my concern. Thank you.
All right, anybody else wishing to address the board?
Good evening. My name is Dion Wright. I live at 2307 Fairmont Avenue. And I will be brief. I just want to point out, Mr. Everito, that we have tried and tried to, I will beg you and plead you to give us more options. Now that we have options, it seems to me that you're only giving us one option, that we have to go with the private sale of water. This has been going on for a while about the water issue. So, I mean, we elect you to represent us, and we're pleading with you to say this is not a good decision to sell the water. I mean, we're paying a lawsuit back because we tried before. I'll say we, meaning that the board decided at one point to privatize it as far as manage it, it didn't work. So now we're at the point where you just want to just throw your hands up and sell it. But my point is that you're only mentioning one particular company to sell it to. I mean, now that we have options, we're asking you to at least hold out on a decision and don't be haste to just, okay, let's just sell it. I mean, are you running for election in 2020, 21? I mean, we like you, Mr. Abelico, but we're asking you as a community to give us options. And now that we have the options, why go against it? I mean, what will it have to give more time? I mean, we've been going through this for, what, 40 years now? That's all I have to say. Just think about it.
All right, thank you very much for your comments. One thing I want to say real quick, I forgot when the school board president was here. I know a lot of people are from the Fairmont area here today. When you leave tonight, I want you to notice our art display that's on the wall there from the Fairmont School. So it's all our students from Fairmont this month. So enjoy it. They did a really nice job. Any other citizens wishing to address the board?
My name is Carl Hedrick. I live in Lockport, Connecticut. I'd like to address my comments specifically to DeMorelli's concern about timing relative to this decision that we're about to make. All right.
Tim, just 1 minute. I'd like to commend all the people that came out and speak and everybody that's come to this meeting tonight, because I do go to a lot of different public meetings, and this is one of the most well-attended and brought up very good points in all your comments. So, Delinda, with you guys getting their awards for being a community that's involved, I do have to commend you all. Give yourself a hand, a round of applause.
Said, I believe that this board possibly is not the right fit for the Fairmont water system, and I do believe elsewhere is the right thing to do. Do I believe selling it to a private company is the right thing? Personally, no, I do not. The way the system was set up, if you dig through the paperwork, which is really hard to do, but you can find it, the federal government installed that system for a reason, and they had it laid out to where Lockport City and Joliet City would eventually take it over. So I base it on that was their intentions, and that's the way it should go. Whether or not Joliet will step up to the plate and do it, like they said, it looks good, it's going in the right direction. Is it going to happen? I don't know until it happens. So, but like I said, I just want to let you know that I'm on the page where I also don't feel like most of the people here that that's the right fit to sell.
Anybody else? All right, my turn. I waited till last. As you know, let's see if I can put this in chronological order for everybody. Well, we've been working on this thing for over 2 years now. So I don't want anybody to think that we're taking this lightly. We don't believe that what we're doing is not in the best interest of the Fairmont community. We, you know, all this talk about we won't have to live with it, we don't really care. I care deeply about this. I'm a little bit offended by that, because we've been dragging this along for 2 years trying to get to the right decision. We've been talking to Lockport and Joliet over the years, for years, trying to get them to step up, and they've always said no. I have to hand it to Joliet now. I have a lot of respect for the city and a lot of respect for Will County for finally stepping up, but it is the 11th hour. And we've been doing this for a long time. And if it doesn't come to fruition with Joliet in Will County, then we're back to square one. And that's the issue that really scares me the most. That being said, as you came in, I don't know if everybody got an agenda. We don't have anything on the agenda tonight that really that we can vote in. So we're not going to vote tonight. We are going to put in another month, because I feel I don't want to rush this any more than anybody else wants to rush it. But we will. I don't want to say table it, because it's nothing to table. It's not on the agenda. We hear you. I feel we hear you. I don't know if the rest of the board feels, but I feel we hear you. We're trying to do the best we can. But at the end of the day, as Dean has said, and everybody has said, even the Fairmont community has said, that this board should not be running this. We need to find somebody to run this. And if Lockport and Joliet aren't going to step up, and we've offered it to the community to become their own water district, and that was told no. We were told we weren't supposed to run it. We run out of options eventually. But that being said, I want to, with all everything in my heart tells me, let's put it off a month and see where this goes. I have to say that Dean is correct with we seem to be the last one to hear the news when everything's going on. I know there's been talk between Joliet and the county, and we've been left out of the loop until today. I finally received some emails. So, over the weekend. So that being said, we aren't going to vote on it tonight. I hope that makes everybody feel a little bit better. We do take it very serious, our job, and what we think for the Fairmont community. We worked hard on this referendum, and it passed. Hopefully we can get that settled. We 30 days here and get some good dialogue and some meetings between Joliet, the county, and myself. I really would love to see it. I'll come to any meeting anytime that I can, unless I can't. But I will change my schedule to be at any meetings. That being said, we'll move on to the rest of our agenda. Thank you, everybody, for your comments, though. They're all very valuable. Utility management. Larry is out of town today, so we won't have a report on him. 13 construction?
No, I shut it off.
Okay. Old business, obviously, the transfer to the water district, the water department. That's been discussed. We talked about it. We pretty much said everything I was going to say anyway. So we'll move on. Under new business, we have the executive session minutes, and it was our attorney's recommendations that we keep them closed, so I do need a motion to keep the minutes closed.
I'll make that motion.
I've got a motion by Barb Boyce, or Barb Delaney.
Second.
And a second by Barb Boyce. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Ayes have it. All right, everybody should have in their packet. So, do we have that to hand out? Or is it in the packets? The budget.
It's in your packets.
We did put our budget together for next year. Basically, the same as last year's. We haven't really changed anything. We'll just keep the line items going. This is a pretty easy budget. We don't have that much money to budget anyway. But are there any questions about it? Have you guys had a chance to look it through at all?
I did briefly, and as you know, Trustee Morelli and myself were not at the workshop.
Didn't discuss this one at all.
Oh, not that.
No, this is the water. This is the water.
Oh, I'm sorry.
This is just the water budget here.
Okay,
all right.
For
the water department.
Then I don't have a question.
Okay.
So you didn't discuss the water budget at the meeting? You did not discuss.
No,
okay.
Does anybody have an issue with the, can we go ahead and, well, it's really for discussion. We'll pass it. I don't want to pass it tonight. It was really for your information tonight to get it out and look at it. I do want to, I forgot, this budget we never used to in the old days. We just pass it because it's just a water district. But I do want to display it just like the account budget and post it. So once we're okay with it, if you guys are okay with it, I will go ahead and publish it and publish the notice that it's on display.
If you don't mind, I would like a chance to review it.
All right.
Okay. I'm not seeing it in my packet. I'm sure it's in there.
It's just a single page.
The law is that the town or the town budget is we put it in the paper that it'll be on display for 30 days in the clerk's office. Last year we put the water budget also on display at the same time. It has to sit under for 30 days, and then at the next following meeting we can vote on it. So that's what my plan is. I just get it out to you guys so you can look at it. We can change the budget at any time up until the vote. So.
Well, I guess one question I would have, are there any pay increases for individuals in this department?
I don't believe there are. No.
Okay, so there's no pay increases?
No.
Okay.
Any other questions in the budget? I will go ahead. this with our other budget once we get that worked out and display it. It will be good. Okay, moving on, the chairman's report. I did get a letter, again, with all the...
Oh, wait a minute, I'm sorry. That's why I wanted a chance to look at this instead of just approving it, because I just asked a question if there was any increase, and on the second page, it says that there's a 5% increase under administrative. So is there not?
The 5% increase under administration is the water coming in.
Yeah.
The amount of bills.
Yeah, there's an ordinance in place that the water bills go up 5% every year. That's
okay.
Been an ordinance for years.
All right, but again, that's why I would just like a chance to review it. So.
Well, that's fine. I thought you were asking if any employees were getting raises. All right, well, I'll display it. Get that going. I did receive a letter from Chris saying it's recommended not to send a check for the infrastructure again for this month, $5,000, since we're kind of catching up on the wells being rehabbed and the big water main breaks that we had. So we're a little tight this last couple of 3 or 4 months. So I'll take a motion not to send a check over to the infrastructure maintenance account.
I'll make that motion.
Anyway, motion by Barb Corrine.
I'll second.
Second by Barb Poyce. All in favor?
Aye.
I'm sorry, that's revolving line. Let's take a roll call.
Ron Alvarito?
Yes.
Greg Vickers?
Yes.
Barb Poyce?
Yes.
Barb Delaney?
Yes.
Steve Morelli?
Yes.
All right. Now then, I would like to go into an executive session tonight for C6 and C1. Consideration of litigation, pending litigation against, affecting, or on behalf of the public body, real estate purchase or sale, and or personal appointment, employment, compensation, discipline, dismissal of an employee, review of closed session minutes, if called by the board, action may be taken afterwards. All right, so we'll take a motion to go into recess and go into executive session.
I'll make that motion.
Okay, motion.